It is Dr. Centeno, and I'd like to talk to you this morning about inside knee pain and a curious case, one of my patients who had damage caused by ACL reconstruction. So because we can now routinely fix most damaged ACLs via precise injection with the patient's own stem cells, you know, I've sent very, very few patients for ACL reconstruction that have ACL tears. And I've also become more aware of the damage done by ACL surgeries. So there are many different areas of the knee routinely damaged by ACL surgery. I'm just going to go over a few here. So number one is the surgeon has to remove the fat pad in the knee or the fat pads, or several, in order to get a clear view of the ACL. Now, regrettably, those fat pads have stem cells. I've also seen a lot of damage to a ligament that holds the inside and outside meniscus together, and damage to the pes anserine tendon caused by the graft tunnel, which is where we're going to focus today. So this is the pes anserine tendon. It's made of three different muscles and attaches on the inside of your knee below the joint. And in this case, this is the location of the tibial graft tunnel. That's where the surgeon drilled a tunnel in order to put the ACL graft. The problem is he also went right through this important tendon. So this is a patient who's had pain in this site for many, many years. The MRI really didn't visualize it, and no one's really ever looked at this spot where she's had pain for all these years. So you see there, this is an ultrasound image. That's the pes anserine tendon that I've bolded in yellow there. And that's the tibial bone underneath. So what we're seeing here is a significant break in the tendon. And so we see tendon fibers coming over this way. We see tendon fibers coming that way. But then we see this mess in the middle right here. And I'm going to now go across that and show you that, again, this is the graft tunnel here now. You're starting to see the graft tunnel that was drilled by the surgeon. And you've got normal tendon here. You've got normal tendon there. And then you've got this absolute mess in here where they drilled through. And again, same thing here. And we're starting to get to an area where she's had some healing in here of the tendon. And then those are just on either side. So the treatment, well, number one is first, don't do this. Don't place a graft tunnel through an important tendon. But if it does happen, bone marrow concentrate is what we'll be using. So that's a same-day stem cell injection procedure under ultrasound guidance into those pes tendons to try to heal that area. So thanks so much for watching. Have a great day, and please subscribe.